Hey, my name is Cole. I am one of the software engineers on the device cloud team here at Particle. I've been working on Logic and Ledger with the team for the last year, and today we're going to do a quick walkthrough of Logic. We'll be covering why we built Logic, what it is, what it's capable of, and a few of the limitations that it currently has. So let's get started. The first thing that we're going to cover is why Logic? Well, we wanted to give customers the ability to extend their IoT products into the cloud. And with Logic, we can give them that by allowing them to do custom data transformations, aggregations, integrations, all in the cloud without having to update device firmware. We built Logic to be as user-friendly and easy to use as possible, while still being extremely powerful. And we're going to keep updating it in the future with more device interactions, as well as Ledger, which is coming soon, which will allow data storage and synchronization between the cloud and devices. So what are logic functions? Logic functions allow you to run JavaScript code in the cloud, and they are executed whenever specified by their logic triggers. There are a few different types of logic triggers. The first one and main one that you'll probably use the most is event-driven logic triggers. So these can trigger your logic functions whenever an event comes from a device or webhook responses or anything that you're used to in the normal Particle cloud and are extremely powerful. You can also set them to execute on specific schedules using cron syntax. And in the future, you'll be able to execute logic functions when a ledger changes, such as when it's either set or deleted. And you can basically subscribe to those changes and execute the logic function on when they happen. And you'll obviously want to keep track of when a logic function actually runs and review that and what's happening in your system. And so you can do that with the logic run system. So this is a logic run is when a logic function is run. And with it, you can access the start and end times of its execution, as well as its status, success, failure, timeout. Success would just be your function ran as normal. No exceptions popped up. Nothing happened out of the ordinary. Just it ran successfully. Failure could be that you threw an error as the user, or maybe you had an unexpected error from one of our libraries. And a timeout would be if you actually ran over the 30-second limit that you have for individual logic function executions. And you can also access any logs that are output by the user or a runtime within a logic run. And so you might actually be wondering how you actually can log, and it's just the way that you're used to in JavaScript. So you can use console.log, warn, or error, and we will record anything that you throw into those, any objects or strings or numbers or anything at all. It will all be recorded and accessible within a logic run. And we also have a few core libraries that we've provided. And so the first one is Particle Core. And currently it just has the ability to publish to the Particle event system. So you could trigger something to happen on an event, or you could trigger an integration or anything else that you're normally used to with the Particle event system you can do here. We also have a few vendor libraries such as Lodash, date functions, as well as CBORX and Unishocks2, which are encoding and compression libraries. And if you want us to support anything else specific in the future, please let us know at community.particle.io. We'll be adding more as people ask and we see fit. There are a few limits to sandbox counts. One that I mentioned before was the 30-second maximum runtime for each function execution. Another is that you can only have a total of 20 logic functions per sandbox count and only 5 logic triggers per logic function. And only 100 logic runs and logs are accessible per logic function within a sandbox count. So let's jump over to console.particle.io and start hacking with your logic functions. Today we are going to be demoing the two different types of things that can trigger them, events as well as schedules. And so we're going to start the demo on the logic page, which you can access on the console over on the left panel here. And we're going to start with creating a scheduled logic function. So we will go up to create new logic function and select the scheduled function template. And we are going to name this 50%. And we're going to ignore the description. And then from there, we can actually write our little function. And so when you're writing a function, you can do any normal JavaScript things that you want to do. So if you want to console.log starting function, then you can do that and you'll be able to access that later. But this function is going to specifically be demoing what happens when a function throws an unexpected error, or in this case, an expected error, by just calling math.random and checking if it's greater than 0.5. So 50% of the time when this function runs, it will enter this block, and we are going to throw a new error just saying failed. And then if it doesn't actually enter that block, then we will console.log passed, and that should be a working function. And so we're going to run the code because you have to run your code successfully at least once to continue. And so, like I said, 50% of the time we're going to pass. And so we can see the logs output from our function right here. So starting function and then passed. And we can run it again to see, yep, 50% failure, starting function, and then a stack trace showing the error. So you can use this to throw any specific errors that you want to if you want to mark things as failed, or you could, if you just passed in something wrong into a library that you're using, then it might throw an unexpected error. And so you'll have to try and catch things as you normally do with JavaScript. And so we'll run again so that we can move forward. And then you have to define your actual schedule. And so we are going to have this function run every minute. If you're not familiar with cron schedules, you can look those up, and there's a lot of details on exactly what each of these means. But if, for example, we change this to a 1, then it will still be every minute, but now it will only be between the hours of 1 a.m. and 2 a.m. And there's lots of other things that you can do with these, but we're just going to have this one run every minute, and we will deploy this function. And so you can see this function has been deployed, and each minute on the minute, this function will execute, and we'll be able to see the list of actual runs here. Now we're going to demo a quick event-triggered function. In this function, you can see that it does quite a bit more than the other one, and we also import some extra fancy libraries here. Some are our own provided libraries, Particle Core and Particle Encoding. And others are vendor packages that you could access in your normal JavaScript ecosystems. In this function, we start by taking in the event data that came with the event that triggered the execution of this function, and grabbing it and putting it into its own variable, and then republishing it out in a few different ways. Base64 encoded, Base85 encoded, CBOR encoded, as well as compressed using the Unishox2 package. And if we go up to the top of the page, we can go to the triggers tab, and we can see that it will be triggered by events from the demo product that I have with the event name and code. And so if we go over to the events page in the console, we can actually publish an event called encode that says hello world. And when we send that off, we'll see that it triggers the function, and we get 4 publishes directly from logic, all with the encoding encoded in these various methods. Okay, so we're in triggers. And so now that we just saw it actually trigger the function, we can actually go over to the runs tab, and we can see that it was executed on December 14th at 3:42. And if we open it up, we'll see it was a success. And we have our debug logs from the runtime that tell us that we were interacting with external systems. So we were publishing events called Base64, Base85, CBOR, and Unishox to my product ID. And so now that the function has executed, we can come back to the runs tab, and we can see it in the execution history. You can see right here, December 14th, 3:42. And since we didn't log anything ourselves, which would show up here, we'll just see the debug logs from the runtime that says that we published our 4 events to this product ID. And now that our function has successfully executed, we can come back over to the runs tab on the function, and we can see that it was executed here. and that it was a success. And we'll be able to see the debug logs from the runtime, and anything else that you would have logged here in your function would also show up in line, as well as you can see the timestamps of each of the individual logs in case. And now that our function has successfully executed once, we can come back over to the runs tab and we can see this last run is the run that we just ran, and open that up to see the debug logs as well as anything else that you would have manually logged with console.log, warning or error. With the debug logs, it will log anything anytime you're interacting with any external resources. So when Ledger comes out, you'll be able to see those logs there as well. But for now, we just have publishing. Then we can also go look back at the logs from our 50% function that we wrote earlier. And we can go over to runs and we can see we've had quite a few successes, quite a few failures. And so we can open them up and we can see the successes have those same logs that we saw earlier, starting function passed, and the failures have the same logs we also saw earlier, starting function, and then the error logged here in red. Thanks for watching. To start using logic, you can visit console.particle.io. And if you have any questions about logic or anything particle, head to community.particle.io and make a post.